trying to do is come up with a permanent solution to plays and musicals that we do with a lot of settings. And in those settings, you have to be able to change things very quickly. My recommendation is that we install, and we get professionals to help us install, a two-part revolve. So the inside part will revolve, and the outside part will revolve. And they can revolve independently of one another or together as a whole. These would be attached to mechanical winches so that you can just press a button and the revolve starts to happen. And these would be done on a permanent basis. So we would build the revolve on top of the stage that already exists, and it would stay there for everything. Because every musical or play that we try to do, we have a lot of scene changes. And with not a lot of wing space and no fly space, scene changes are next to impossible. So we end up creating things like small platforms that turn to be multiple different things to save time, but that sacrifices the quality of our scenic design. So if we want to achieve our dreams, we need to get this revolve on stage. We have a huge season coming up next year, and the plays that I have been putting in for rights, the plays and musicals that I've been putting in for rights, have multiple scene changes and big casts. This revolve would help us immensely. We would spend less time figuring out design flaws and more time investing and implementing the designs that are in our brains. And that's where we really want to be. With a big tech class of 50 people, there's no reason that we shouldn't be on stage designing what we can think of, our wildest dreams and imagination, and being the best high school theater that we can possibly be. There's a million different settings that we can accurately portray on stage. There is a son's bedroom, a parent's bedroom, a house, a million daffodils. The stage at one point gets flooded with millions of daffodils. There's a college campus, there's a town square, there's a circus, there's a forest, there's a pond, a lake. I mean, there's so many different locations, but it's not just something you can add a little gilly platform for. We need to transform the entire stage at one time in 5 seconds, which a revolve will let us do. And I've been in Twitter contact with the people from Big Fish that were in the show, and they're coming to see our show.
Whoa.
Yes, they're coming to see our show. We're the premiere, they're coming to see it. They want to see it. They want to see how this translates into a smaller space and what we can do with it. We cannot go out there and half-ass this. We have got to have the most wonderful, brilliant production of Big Fish that's ever existed outside of Broadway and Chicago. There's no time like the present. This is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Premiering a show doesn't happen to high schools. It just doesn't happen. But it's happening for us. We are signed, sealed, delivered. The contract is submitted. The school's approved it. We are doing this show. And it's gonna rock. And everyone from the community is gonna wanna see it because it ran on Broadway for such a short time that people are like, oh, I missed it. I love the movie. Why didn't I get to go? They're gonna flood our high school. But we can do it. This is outside of production expenses. There's $20,000 out there in rights that we still have to pay for the shows. $20,000 just to put up the shows. And then the budget for Annie was $30,000. So we need $30,000 to do the show. That's one show. We're looking at $100,000 here. That's just to build the revolve and put up Big Fish. We're looking at $100,000. Now, I'm not talking little money. I don't do little theater. I'm not talking little money. But $100,000 to a community theater is a healthy budget. We do community style theater here. Let's make this a community theater.
We're not gonna pay. We're not gonna pay.